So close. This hand might be terrible. If I went to 5 and saw Urza's Mine open the vaults, Krark-Clan Ironworks defense good Chromatic Star, I would think that's a pretty good 5. But if I went to 6, I think this is worse than the average 6. It's pretty close though. If someone kept this, I wouldn't like think it was the craziest thing ever. But I'm not going to, even on the draw. This hand's better. Potential turn 3 win, but it's very unlikely. We would need, like, draw 1 mana artifact. Okay, well, we're off to a good start. And then we would need a couple other good draws in the middle here, and we would need him to not have a counter spell. Oh, okay. So he's playing one of those Cryptic Command Eternal Witness decks. That makes a lot of sense. Yeah, what base green deck? No, don't spell snare that. I need that for the draw and the metal craft and all my things. Ah. Yeah, I was trying to think of a base green deck because his bolting himself for a green source in game one, like obviously revealed that he was playing a green deck, and I was trying to think of a base green deck that would play like cantrips, but it wouldn't have a one drop, even the a one drop green card, even Valakut runs a one drop green card. Sword of Feast and Famine, go. Well, that's scary. I crack this Chromatic Star. It's kind of close. Kind of want to, and I kind of don't want to. If I just naturally draw another star next turn, I'll be able to go Mox Opal, Star Krark-Clan. I think I should just sacrifice this. Dig deeper into my deck. Oh no. All right. We're in pretty rough shape this game. Interesting to see what he casts here, because he has a Vylon too. Okay, so that implies that he has another 2-drop that he's gonna Vial in, so he's definitely hitting us with the sword. Scavenging Ooze is kind of tricky to win through with Open the Vaults, but you can definitely do it. Usually you just overpower it. I was going to play this Krark-Clan Ironworks and hope he doesn't have Spell Pierce for me. It seemed pretty safe. Oh no. Yeah, we're in pretty rough shape here. So this is interesting. I like the Scavenging Ooze a lot. Looks really good with the Sword of Feast and Famine here too. He just gets to pump it for free. Untap all of his lands. He might not actually be playing Cryptic Command, because right now we can see a forest and a temple garden among his mana base. And if you're playing Cryptic Command, you're keeping the number of those cards to a minimum. And I think you probably want some kind of man land in there. I guess you can play Colonnade though, and that one taps for Cryptic. Yeah, Colonnade seems sick in this deck. Because he's still a Vial to like put in creatures and stuff. I'm gonna take five here. Our margin of victory is very small right now. So I can discard this Mox Opal. For some reason, he didn't pump his scavenging ooze. Not that it really matters. Needle, sure. Let's give a name, Krark-Clan Ironworks, and I think we're just dead. Oh, that's a mana ability, right? Paving Needle says not a mana ability. Yeah, silly me. He can't name Krark-Clan Ironworks. I actually don't know what he's going to name with his Pithing Needle. I don't think it names anything in my deck. Yeah, he named it. I can certainly still activate it. Certainly a mana ability. That's the Urzatron. It's a little awkward here, because if I play it, I'll have 5 mana, but not but not actual 5 mana. I think it's still correct. We're going to have to discard a card, and it's going to end up being this Tezzeret. Oh well. We can still win this if we top deck open the vaults, because we have enough mana to cast it now. Oh no, that doesn't work. We don't have a second white source. So we don't have an artifact for the Mox Opal. Maybe I should have waited a turn to crack the Chromatic Sphere. That was probably better. Targeting Thirst for Knowledge. Okay, yeah, that's fine. I think he's digging for mana leak plus the extra land to cast it. Yeah. So he can leak us on our next turn. It doesn't really matter because we have an excess of mana. Maybe if he had a negate or a removal spell for one of our artifacts, that would be pretty good. Like another Pride Mage or something. No, Tezzeret, you are my favorite Tezzeret. Yeah, we're not even close to that, right? Yeah, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh well. That was an awkward game. Super awkward. I'm really happy that one of his plans is to needle naming Krark-Clan Ironworks. I hope he does that again. And I hope that we get to show him why that's not a good name. Yeah, I don't think needle does anything in this deck. You can stop Mindstone from cycling. You can name Tezzeret the Seeker. He might actually just do that, so this actually isn't bad. The shaving one for the thirst. Yeah, I like that. He might cut counter magic now that we showed him defense grid, so shaving one, bring Mindstone back in isn't the worst idea ever. We could also bring the land back in because we're on the play and we're going to need it to hit land drops a little bit more. I kind of like that idea. It's a good idea, yeah. Just jamming this.